To be perfectly honest, I think this is a terrible idea. Everyone agreed to leave things as they were.
I will, as much as I can. But from what Rutland said, I'm sure there's a clue down there about what killed my mother. I have to go back.
There's no use trying to enter at the same point. It's caved in.
The river had to get in there somehow.
I'll leave you to figure out the how. I can't go down there. I'm sorry.
It's fine, really. If there's any trouble, call Zip and he'll patch you through. Don't take any chances. I'm not losing any more of my friends.
So, how are you getting in?
The same way as the water, I hope. If you get a call from Anaya, patch her through straight away. I'm a little concerned about leaving her by herself.
I'll keep her company.
Lost and raised by a warrior. She became queen after a shaman named Tunupa discovered her royal heritage.
Tunupa is another name for Viracocha, their god of creation.
The shaman brought her to Lake Titicaca, where she borrowed his staff, an object of great power.
According to myth, Viracocha originally lived in the lake.
The god of indoor plumbing.
She led her people into an era of peace. After many years of wise and just rule, there was some sort of power struggle. She died shortly thereafter, and she was carried off in a boat to paradise.
Remind you of something?
The King Arthur myth. Yes, the similarities are striking.
King Arthur? A little help here?
It's the same story. A youth, unaware of his royal blood, rises from obscurity to become a wise king with the help of a friendly wizard and his magical staff or sword. And afterwards, he's transported to paradise.
Many cultures share similar legends. The Great Flood, for example. Everyone's got that one, too.
You could be right. That's a mechanism. That's a mechanism.
Oh, now that's pretty cool.
That's something I could move.
You should be able to move that, if it's any help.
Set into it, or in this case, Vitacocha's staff. This is it.
Do you believe it's the same one we saw in Tiwanaku?
There's more than just one Deus, but possibly.
So the shaman would be Merlin, and the staff would be whatever the hell King Arthur's sword was called.
It's called coincidence.
Funny name for a sword.
This is a tomb. I'll make them feel at home.